simplify your life, especially during your leisure time? Let's discover how with Pasquale Scopelliti, CEO at Snowit. Okay, hi Pasquale, how are you doing? Thanks for being with us today.
Hi Matteo, thanks for the invitation. So it's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you, our pleasure. So I would like you to introduce yourself to our followers and to explain what Snowit is about.
Yes, I'm Pasquale. I'm the founder of a company called Snowit. I found Snowit 3 years ago after an experience in a big consulting company. So I'm a former strategy consultant. But 3 years ago, I decided that I wanted to be an entrepreneur. So I want to do something on my own. And with a former colleague, we started Snowit, that is a startup dedicated to winter sports. Basically, what we created in these 3 years is a platform where all the services related to winter sports are available to be booked digitally. So I'm talking about the ski pass, the rent of the ski equipment, the booking of ski lessons, experience, hotel. So all these products that you normally need to organize a full holiday on the snow. It's a very interesting market because it's not digitalized yet, because you know, these kind of products normally to be booked, you need to call directly the rent shop or the ski school. So it's very complicated to book a full holiday on the snow on the net. That's why today many people that are traveling for a ski holiday, they still use the traditional travel agencies that have you know, a pre-packaged holiday for you. Mm-hmm. But with Snowit, we give the possibility to the user to build their own holiday, to have the best service, and to also have advanced digital services. In fact, for example, for the ski pass, we give the possibility to the user to charge their own ski pass card in order to go directly to the lift without spending time at the cashier desk. So basically, we are like Expedia, but for winter holidays.
I understand. For now, are you focusing only on the Italian Alps, or are you focusing in a broader landscape?
Well, our vision is to be present in all the Alps. Of course, now the majority of our offer is focused on the Italian Alps, even because, you know, when you think about Italy, you think about food, about fashion, and about mountains, no? So it's really a strong asset for Italy. We have beautiful mountains. So we started from our market. But we already have, since next season, we will be present also in France, Switzerland, and Austria. So it's the first season in which we really have a big offer also in the rest of the Alps.
I see. So it's definitely a scalable model. What was the trigger that convinced you to move from being a strategy consultant to a startup?
Well, I always say that in order to start to be an entrepreneur, especially if you have to leave another career, you need three things. First of all, you need really to feel that you want to be an entrepreneur. So when I was a strategy consultant, I loved the job, but I was kind of feeling that something was missing in my life, no? So that was a big trigger for to make a change. The second thing was the idea. I mean, you have to find something that you are really passionate about, that you really think that can have a high potential, something that you can really want to invest your time. When I was working on a big project for a client, we had the opportunity to analyze the sport market in general. So we realized that the ski market was really a big opportunity for digitalization. The third thing is to find the right co-founder. That's also important because, you know, doing a startup all alone, it can be really, really tough. I was very lucky because I found a colleague of mine that has the same passion for winter sports, that he was also willing to become an entrepreneur, so to start a new business. And that was a big trigger for me, because doing that together helped a lot to get where we are now. So Ricardo is my co-founder. He had a very important part in this decision.
What were the challenges that you faced at the very beginning and even now? And what are the solutions that you found to these challenges?
So look, Matteo, we are basically a marketplace, because on one side we have to create the offer, so going to ski station, rental shops and ski school and convince them to enter into the platform. On the other end, we have to create the user side. So we need user that come to the platform and buys the products. So that's a typical challenge on a marketplace, because in order to have the offer, you need the user. In order to have the user, you need the offer. So that was the really big challenge at the beginning. And the way we solve it was to find a way to create the user side without having the offer side. In fact, at the very beginning, we started not with a marketplace, but with an app that was basically an engagement app. It was an app dedicated to skiers that allowed them to track their ski days. So basically like a Runtastic, but for skis. Mm-hmm. So we did that, first product. We try to make it as engagement as possible. So in the app, you had also, you know, challenge between users, who was doing more kilometers and so on. That helped a lot, because the first year, this product was really a big success, because with a limited budget, we had more than 30,000 registered users on the app. And that was the thing that helped a lot us to start, because at that point we had the community, we had users, and we used that community to go to the ski station and so on and convince them to be part of the project. And from that moment, everything started, because once you start to have the user and bring offer into the marketplace, at that point it's easier to grow and grow faster from that moment on.
Yeah, there is the so-called hockey stick. Where did you find the capital? What are the ways you used to address this issue?
Well, we started with the classical fools, family and friends. So we had people in our network that believed in us, believed in the idea. So we start with a very, very small amount of money. That was the first step. Second step was business angel. So we found 10 different individual people interested to invest in the idea. And we did a third operation that was using the crowdfunding. So crowdfunding was a very important step for us, because we did a crowdfunding campaign 1 year and a half ago that was pretty successful, because we were able to have a campaign for €450,000. That for the Italian market is a good result.
Yeah,
and so that was very important. Now at this step, we are at a point where we are we need more capital, so bigger capital to scale the company. We are working on two different ways. That is traditional venture capital. Snowit now it's a company that is close to scale up, so it's ready for basically a Series A round. But also we are working on developing a corporate partnership, so company that are interested in this market and sees Snowit as a way to speed the innovation process. So there are many companies in the travel sector, in the mobility sector, in the tourism sector that look at Snowit as an opportunity to win digitally in this market.
I guess that one of the issues that this kind of business models that are focused on online presence is the replicability. I mean, there is probably a number of challengers out there that will be ready to copy your idea in the moment that is successful. How do you defend Snowit from that?
Well, as was hard to start for us, is very hard to start for everyone else, because our main defense from possible new entries in the market is the network effect, in the sense that a copycat or a new entry would be quite hard to replicate the model, in the sense that you have to create the demand side, you have to create the user side, so that requires time. So at the moment, we have already 3 years of advantage from someone that want to start something similar. We believe that can be a good advantage, of course. The second thing is technology. We work a lot on technology. We believe that also is very important. Technology helps you to give a better service to the user, better service to the partners. So we're really a technology company. We have an important part in our team that is dedicated to development of our technology platform. And we have developed a solution that we believe that are pretty advanced and not so easy to be replicated.
And I know that you have another project coming out, or already come out, which is called Bykit. Do you want to spend 1 minute talking about that?
Yes, of course, because actually the name of our company is not Snowit, but is Fortit. Because when we created the company, we already had a vision that the same thing that we are doing in the winter sports market can be replicated in different sports sector. Because at the end, if you're passionate about sports, you want to travel, you need your equipment, you need a lesson, you need a place where to stay. So, of course, the winter sector is one of the most rich, most important, but also we started to look 1 year ago at the bike sector. So all the tourism correlated to the to bike excursion, mountain bike. So we created a brand that is the small brother of Snowit. It's called Bykit. That is a marketplace where you can rent your bike, e-bike, mountain bike in different locations. You can book experience related to your bike tour, accommodation. So basically, you can create your bike holiday completely online with the best service available on the market.
I see. And just before closing our interview, we have a couple of minutes more. As one of the purpose of Italians is to support companies like yours to take off, I want to give you a couple of minutes to pitch Snowit and Bykit and the rest of your ideas to eventual investors or eventual customers.
Yeah, actually, we are looking now for international partners because, of course, we are now looking at developing our international presence. So we are really interested in collaboration with international tour operators that can be interesting partner for us. For them, Snowit can be really a platform that they can use to build holiday package to be sold through their channels. So basically, the same thing that we do for users, so we bring those products that normally can be booked just locally, we do the same things also for tour operators that normally can hardly access to local activities. So it's a big opportunity for them because they can offer full, completely service to their customers. And it's a system that works in a completely scalable and digital way, so very easy to be integrated. So we would be happy to be contacted by everyone that works in the tourism sector and can be interested in our collaboration with Snowit.
And I really hope that among the people that are watching us right now, you will find some of them. Pasquale, let me thank you very much for being here with us today, and let me wrap up what we said today.
Thank you very much, Matteo.
Today, thanks to Pasquale, we learned that number one, the first step to create a marketplace is to have a user base. Number two, capital must not be an obstacle. Good ideas will always find financing. Have good ideas first. Number three, if you're working in tourism and you want to leverage the Snowit platform, just do that. Contact Pasquale at the link that you will find in the description of this video down here. All right, if you enjoy your time with us today, please hit the like button and subscribe our channel in order to see more videos like this in the future. Thanks to the Danubius Hotel in Regent's Park, London for hosting us, and see you soon. Cheers and ciao!